Hi folks, it's Cassie here from Greensock. Today we're going to be taking a look at keyframes. You might be familiar with them from CSS. Here we're animating this box in a square movement using four keyframes. But why do we need keyframes in GSAP? We already have tweens and timelines, right? Let's take a look at the same movement but using a timeline. So we're going to create our timeline and then we're going to add our first tween to animate the box to the right. And then once we've got this, we need to repeat it four more times. So we're going to move the box down 100 pixels and then left 100 pixels and then back up again. So this is a little bit repetitive because we have to write out a new tween for the same target each time. Keyframes can help us keep our code nice and concise. So there's three different ways to write keyframes, but let's take a look at object-based keyframes first. We're going to write out a tween instead of a timeline this time, and then within this tween, we're going to create an array of keyframes. And we're going to repeat the movement again, so we're going to move the box to the right, and then down, and then left, and then back up again. By default, keyframes have a duration of 0.5, and they're sequenced back-to-back, just like tweens on a timeline, so you can see this movement is exactly the same. We can offset these tweens by adding a delay value. So now the box is going to pause for a second before moving down. If you wanted to create an overlap, you could just use a negative number instead. So here's a cool bit. We can ease the entire keyframe sequence by applying an ease to the tween itself. If we were using a timeline, we'd have to animate the progress of that timeline to get this effect. So this is really nice and easy. We can also apply per keyframe eases. The default per keyframe ease for object keyframes is linear. We can also animate some properties in the keyframe block and then some in the tween itself. So let's add a little rotate. And then the box will spin around its center as it moves through the keyframe positions. And because these objects are treated much like normal tweens, we can even pop callbacks in there, like an onComplete. Let's do a callback at the end of the third keyframe. These object keyframes are great for creating concise sequence behavior. They're like handy mini timelines that you can nest inside tweens. But for people more used to CSS keyframes, it can be a bit confusing trying to translate the timings over from percentages. So in 3.9, we added a new percentage option to make it nice and simple to port CSS animations over. So just like CSS, these keyframes are spaced out over the progress of the tween itself, rather than having individual durations. And like CSS, if we omit a property from one of the keyframes, the value gets interpolated across the gap. So if we add a rotate on the third keyframe here, the box will rotate for 75% of the whole tween, stretching over the first three keyframes. The default ease between these keyframes is power 1 in out. This is nice and natural and it's similar to the ease used in CSS keyframes. But these keyframes are more flexible than CSS and have a whole host of different easing options. If you wanted to override this ease on all of the keyframes at once, we've added an ease each property which sits inside the keyframe block. If you want to ease all the keyframes as a whole, you can pop an ease inside the keyframe object too. And like the original object keyframes, you can use individual keyframe eases and callbacks inside the keyframes themselves. If you're also animating properties outside the keyframes, you can use a regular ease in the tween itself to ease them. This flexibility with easing should allow you to really fine-tune your animations. So let's take a look at the last way to write keyframes. This simple array-based option, also added in 3.9, is really great for when you just want to hit certain values in a sequence. The values that we pop into the array get distributed equally over the tween's duration. So we can't specify per keyframe eases here, but we can ease the whole keyframe block as a whole. And like the percentage keyframes, we also have the new ease each property to override the default ease. So this option is a little less flexible, but its power lies in the simplicity. So there we have it, keyframes. They're a great way to write nice, concise code when you're animating one target, like this bouncy ball. Plus, you can mix up different easing combinations to create some really interesting fine-tuned new effects. We hope you have fun experimenting with keyframes. As always, if you get stuck, pop over into our forums at greensock.com/forums. Bye for now and happy tweening.